Hi there, it's naturopath from New Zealand, Eric Backer, author of Candida Crusher and formulator of the Candida dietary supplements. Thanks for checking out my video. We're going to continue on with the SIBO, the small intestinal bacterial overgrowth, or small intestinal bowel overgrowth. There are many different names for this condition. What we've got here is a condition basically where we've got an increase in bacteria in the small intestine, creating all kinds of different problems. So check out my other videos on SIBO to understand a bit more about the condition. So this video is about, why is it so difficult to treat? Why do so many practitioners get it wrong and only have temporary results with SIBO? Well, it's not just SIBO, it's also Candida yeast infections in general that people have a lot of difficulty treating and eradicating in their patients. If we look at SIBO, rifaximin is an antibiotic that's commonly recommended for this condition. So with SIBO, many doctors are actually recommending rifaximin. If we've got doctors like Dr. Alison Seebecker, who's a SIBO specialist, she recommends rifaximin or botanical antimicrobial treatment. The problem with rifaximin and antimicrobial, the natural antimicrobials, is that research has shown that in many cases, in fact, the natural treatment probably works better than rifaximin. But the problem with both treatments is that about half patients have shown through research to have a reoccurrence within 12 months. So I think one of the reasons why, is lifestyle and diet changes are not addressed long-term or sufficiently for patients to get a full recovery. And that's the problem. People seem to be all hell-bent on getting treatment, but when it comes to maintaining good health, this is a whole new ballgame. So when you go to a practitioner and you're not feeling well, you expect a treatment, you expect a resolution. But then when you get well, are you going to maintain a course of a natural, healthy lifestyle and diet to maintain wellness? Or are you going to slowly slide back into drinking alcohol regularly, not getting enough sleep, stressing out, eating the wrong kind of foods, not chewing properly, all these sorts of factors come into play. So if you go back to what you've always done, you'll go back and get what you got in the first place to go back, why you went to the doctor originally. So, it's common sense again. Like I usually say in my videos, most good health is common sense. So don't just focus on treatment. Focus on your long-term strategy. How are you going to stay well for years and years ahead? The gut, the digestive system, is the heart and soul of the person. If you can maintain a high level of wellness in the digestive system, you can maintain a really high level of wellness in the overall, body. In the brain and the immune system, the musculoskeletal system. All of these systems will function optimally if your digestive system is functioning optimally. But in order to get the gut to function optimally, obviously, assessment, I think, is important. Correction and treatment is important, but then maintenance is the golden rule. You've got to maintain a healthy diet and lifestyle to stay well. No rocket science. All these videos I create, there's no rocket science behind them. You don't need to be a brain surgeon to work this out, okay? If your doctor or naturopathic doctor or, integrative doctor, whoever you've seen, has given you recommendations, you've followed them, you've followed a course of treatment, you've improved, why wouldn't you maintain that kind of a treatment plan long, long, long term to get amazing wellness? Why would you slowly slide back into what you did and then get the condition back, and then go to another doctor and say, well, the first doctor was no good, didn't work out, I'm sick again? It's important to look at yourself if you don't fully recover, or if you recover and then relapse back into the condition again. That's why SIBO is difficult to treat, okay? Because I really believe, after having seen patients now for nearly 30 years, that the majority of clients I see end up going back to do what they did when they got sick in the first place. Check out my website, yeastinfection.org. Make sure you do my quiz, my Candida Crusher quiz. You'll find links on that on candidacrusher.com and yeastinfection.org. And do consider my supplements I've created, especially for SIBO and Candida, Candida with an X. So www.candida.com. Thanks for tuning in.